Hey guys, what is going on? Welcome back to the channel. Today is obviously, as you can see behind me, a very good day. I'm shooting with one of my favorite cameras, with one of my favorite cars, and today we are going to be shooting with the Canon R5. Now, to be honest with you, I bought this camera a year ago, and I have never once used 8K RAW. And since then, they have given us access to 8K RAW light, 4K light, IPB, all these kind of different file formats that I've never really taken advantage of. So in this video, I'm gonna be shooting in 8K RAW with this beautiful Porsche GT4 in Miami blue. And then guys, we can review the footage, see how the Apple M1 chip actually handles 8K RAW and how it looks in post. If it's even worth shooting with that codec, and if it's not worth shooting in that codec, why would you get the R5? Let's just take a quick peek around the car. I don't know if you guys remember, it was a while ago, we shot with the Sony a7 III, testing the Sigma 35mm lens with this car, and that's the same lens that we're gonna be shooting on today. So we've got the Canon R5 with the 35mm, the Sigma. We've got the Nessi polarizer filter on the front, and we've got a built-in ND filter slider there. So that's kind of how we're gonna be filming it. We're gonna shoot in 8K, 24 frames per second. So I'm just doing very short clips because the file sizes shooting in 8K RAW are absolutely massive. Now, for those of you who are wondering, I am shooting with Canon C-Log 3, which is added in one of their most recent updates, and their native ISO is 800. So we've got our ISO set and steady at 800, and then we're using the ND filter to create exposure. My aperture is sitting around 2.8. Guys, we're doing a startup on a Porsche GT4 with a Klein exhaust. I guess these are the same, similar guys that do like Formula One type stuff. So give this a listen. All right, give her the beans. Woo! That's what it's about, boys. That's what it's about. We're going to a new spot. Let's go. So we are on the final stretch home. We got some footage with the Canon R5 in raw 8K. So we're gonna bring that back to the computer. I want to see how long it takes to upload, how quick the Apple M1 can navigate the footage. So come with me if you guys are interested back to the office, and we'll see how the footage looks and holds up on the computer. Welcome back to the office, guys. Now, one of the big questions that I had is with the Canon R5 and 8K RAW footage, can the Apple M1, not the M1 Pro or Pro Max, because we know those can handle 8K RAW, but can the typical M1 handle the 8K RAW footage? So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna import the footage. Now, what you can see here is that one file is 9.17 gigabytes. But what we're gonna do here is we're gonna set a stopwatch to see how long it takes the M1 to import these files here. And then from there, the big question is how well can M1 handle scrubbing through the footage, working with the footage. And you know what? I think I'm actually gonna drop some of these R5 clips into a Dropbox. So if you guys are interested in fiddling with it, seeing if it works with your system, I'll drop that down below into a Dropbox so you guys can see how your computer can manage the files. All right, so we've got 7 clips. I'm gonna import them and hit start at the same time, and we'll see how long it takes to go. Okay, so this is clearly gonna take a little bit longer than I thought. It's at 4%, and we're already at a minute. Now, one thing that I will note is that you need to be very intentional with what hard drives you are using. I use the Samsung portable SSD, the T5s. Essentially, whatever you're importing to is gonna be the stoppage in how fast your footage can import. So if you're importing directly onto your desktop or something, that's awesome. But I tend to use the SSD drive. So you definitely have to be thinking about the read and write speeds of each device in your chain, whether it's your computer or your hard drives or your card readers. Well, we are 20% of the way there and it has taken us 5 minutes. So we're just gonna do a little bit of math here and assume that if we're at 20% at 5 minutes, it's gonna take 25 minutes to import. But let me show you how well the M1 chip handles the 8K raw footage. All right, so up here, we've got some of our clips. And as you can see, this clip here, as we drop it down, this clip is a total of 23 seconds. And if we reveal that in our Finder, we will find out that that clip, the CRM clip, is 7.58 gigs. That's crazy. That for me is not worth shooting in 8K, because when you come down here, I was shooting some stuff for some reels and this footage looks phenomenal to me just in 4K IPB. So for me, that, I don't know, it's not as convincing to go to the 8K if you ask me. I don't know what use cases specifically you need to shoot 8K. I'll leave that up to you. But as you come down here, you can see that the scrubbing speed on the timeline is very good. I actually have no gripes with that. If you look up top here, we're on better quality. We're using our optimized media, and let's see how well it plays back. If we lose any frames, tiny bit choppy. Oh yeah, there we go. So now it's chopping up a bit. You can see it has not rendered all the way. Okay, so we do lose frames with 8K footage. Now let's just go up to the top here. We will go to better performance and see if that changes anything. Again, this clip hasn't rendered all the way. Now we're into the unrendered section and we have no
focus.
Tap to focus, there we go. Canon R5 is a beauty in that way. There we go, no dropped clips. So all you have to do is just hit better performance and we're running 8K clips. Let's see if we stack something. So a few drop clips there with two 8K stacked. Now the Canon R5 does give you heaps of options for recording. Like I said earlier, it gives you 8K raw, 8K raw light. You can shoot in 4K all I codecs as well as IPB codecs. So you get a lot of customization with what you want to shoot on the R5. I did have to upgrade my computers to the M1 chip to make sure that I was getting a nice flow in editing. The previous computers that I was working with, which were pretty well stacked iMacs, could not actually handle this footage without creating proxies. So as you get into the Canon ecosystem, whether it is the R5 or the R6, do be aware that if you're shooting with the IPB codecs or 8K RAW, for example, that you may be needing to get into something like the M1 chips, the M1 Pros, the M1 Max, and I will be looking at getting one of the M1 Pro laptops shortly, as soon as they're not out of stock. And I would love to do some more testing with footage in that regard, but I have a feeling based on everything that's out there on YouTube that it's gonna be mind-blowing and phenomenal and really great for videographers and photographers like us. Now, I wanna be clear that this is not a dig at all on Canon and the R5 or the R6 ecosystem, because I love them. I love the footage that I'm getting out of here. The ability to manipulate and color grade this footage is, it's incredible. It's really, really good. I guess all I'm trying to do here is educate you guys as you try and make decisions on camera gear, because $5,000 to drop on one camera is so much money. And if it were me, when I was doing that research, it'd be great to have all the information getting into it. So I do hope that you guys have found this educational, helpful, entertaining a little bit. And if you did, feel free to smash that like button for me. It helps the channel a ton. Feel free to subscribe if you're into photography, cars, videography, that kind of thing. That's what we enjoy doing here. And I'd love it if you stuck around and watched another video. But otherwise, I do hope to see you in the next one. Peace.